Good morning, everybody. I'm going to talk about tools that link pollination services with the environment. This will enable us to identify areas that need improvement. Pollination is a service often provided by insects. For instance, for the pollination of sweet cherry, bees are important pollinators. Yet, the service is delivered by a multitude of different bee species, and we know that yields increase when the abundance of different wild bees is higher. Thus, the endpoint is obvious. Having different wild bees to pollinate your crop is what we want. But how to get there? And was pollination not a free service? How do we get this back? Well, in order to support different wild bees in your environment, you need to understand which landscape elements support these different kinds of bees. To do this, models have been developed which try to predict the abundance of bees present in a specific landscape. Having these kind of validated models, one can simulate changes in the environment and predict the impact of these changes on pollinators and the service they provide. Within Beespoke, we are implementing a model originally described by Erik Lonsdorf. What will the model do? It will estimate pollination services for the EU North Sea region. More specific, it will tell us if the pollination service is good, intermediate, or bad at the location of interest. To do this, we start from a regular map to locate the places of interest. On top of this, we project a layer of land covers. For instance, the different green areas you see are different kinds of grasslands or forest elements, each with their own characteristics. It is the land cover layer which forms the basis of our predictions. The more accurate the land cover data is, the better our predictions are. Based on these land covers, we calculate food quality maps, meaning does a specific land cover provide food for a specific bee? Here, the dark gray areas represent places with high amount of food resources. A next layer is the nesting suitability map. Here, orange areas represent those that provide more suitable nesting habitat compared to the lighter areas. These two maps allow us to predict if a successful bee nest can be present, meaning is the nesting habitat okay and is there enough food in the surrounding environment. Based on the amount of potential bee nests in the environment, we can predict the likely abundance of a pollinator species in the crop of interest, meaning the specific bee considers the crop of interest as a food resource and will forage on it. I said a specific bee. Indeed, different predictions will be generated for different kind of bees. This one here, for instance, this is a mason bee, Osmia cornuta. While for this one, this is a minor bee. Here we show the predictions of Andrena hemarroea. A different bee abundance can be expected. This is because a minor bee nests under the ground, while a mason bee nests above the ground. If we look at the sweat bee, Lasioglossum albipes in this case, you really see a different model output. This is mainly because its foraging distance is much smaller and its presence depends on local scale elements. But okay, what could this mean for you? For instance, for a farmer, it would be great to know the potential pollination service in your crop. But of course, in the wire environment, there are multiple farmers. So on government or cooperation level, one can start to implement landscape planning to sustain optimal pollination service on a broader scale, benefiting multiple stakeholders. Yet we need tools to do this. Within Beespoke, we are implementing different ones. In a first tool, one will be able to put in GPS coordinates to select the area of interest. A field is provided in which the crop of interest can be selected. The crop selection determines for which pollinators the abundance of the pollination service will be predicted. Okay, good. You know, for instance, that pollination services can be improved. But knowing this, how can this be done? Within Beespoke, we are developing different kind of flower mixtures. These are there to support pollinators in different countries of the EU North Sea region. We make use of existing models to calculate the added value of a flower strip. The Bee Steward model, for instance. Here, land use maps are translated into food maps for bumblebee species. It calculates if the environment can support nest development of these species. At the farm level, one can introduce flower strips and see how much additional nests can be supported. Within Beespoke, there are predictions ongoing to look at the size and the distribution of flower strips and assess their added value for bumblebee nest development. But also, an individual can do predictions. For this, a final tool based on the Lonsdorf model will be implemented. Here, one can select the crop and the area of interest. And then, the land covers will be shown. Herein, the user has the ability to add an area which will be changed into a flower strip. The web application will provide an estimate of pollinator increase for those pollinators suited to pollinate your crop of interest. Thus, it can be evaluated where and how big a flower strip must be to support extra pollinators and also to support their valuable service, which is pollination. We highlight that these tools are still under development, and thank you for your attention.